What's up and welcome to Utawarerumono Mask of Truth episode 56. So her sister is... well... yeah.
Nani?
Nani?
Oh.
She's responds immediately.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Oh.
No. Rute looks taken back by her sister's words, and she responds with a shaking voice. Until... she stares at her sister as if unable to comprehend. However, she seems to realize something as she turns to glare at her father and brother. Told them what? Yasma covers slightly under his stare. Oh, wow. She snarls at her brother, then turns to us. Allow me to clarify, okay? She kneels gracefully before Anju as if her foul temper before was all just some dream. Return to me, okay? Well... Sister!
Yeah.
From ya. She merely ignores the desperate cries from her family as she continues on. Happy to exchange. Wow. He's a Wow. Finally, I understand why they seem so flustered by all this. Yeah. Princess Command.
Yeah.
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 Okay, weaken her all three. Over a single girl. Rute bursts out, having had enough. It seems she hadn't taken her opinion into account. But she still seems oblivious. How can you take away such an honor? Ravage of war. Oh, she's already been. I mean, she has been fighting a lot of times, so... Hello. Rute finally steps in between her siblings. At the slightest pain. Well said. Yasma tears up a little as she hears Rute's desperate plea.
Rute,
I never thought I feel so proud. Her father and brother seem moved to tears, but she continues to watch the two of them with cold eyes. Finally, however, she turns to Rute. Very kind indeed. You can ever imagine, yeah? That's how war works. Very sure you will not, yeah. At her sister's words, Rute sags, looking quietly downwards. But Yasma grabs Rute by the shoulder, forcing her to face him as she speaks. Indeed. Overcoming your fear and pain, yeah. You must face it and triumph. That's what we've done. This time. For all the times. Yeah. However, Rute can only manage a troubled smile in response. For a moment, it seems like we were at a standoff, however, Anju raises a voice. I have a suggestion, okay? It's the person's own feelings, is it not? What is your wish? Rute gazes, wavers. She casts around, looking desperately for anybody that can help her. I clench my teeth, seeing Rute's reaction. Sway it to their side. A nonchalant voice breaks the silence, completely unfitting for the tense atmosphere. She glares daggers at the intrusion, but Kuan barely seems to notice, continuing as though she doesn't have a care in the world. I suddenly realize what Kuan is trying to do. Azui seems to notice as well and whines loudly. Vegeta rolls her shoulders with oblivious discomfort. Okay. I whispered to so that only Anju can hear me. Yeah. Anju finally realizes our plan as well. Okay, it's a little forced, but that's enough to do the trick. Olsen hastily bows his head once more. However, Olsen hesitates for a slightest moment, then continues. Anju glances to me in contemplation.
Yeah.
Saved my ass, yeah. Yashma seems relieved that this decision been postponed for a while, but Shiz is clearly not happy. It's clear to her I set this up so that neither of them could try to sway this decision. But I also seems like she understands what it would mean to go against Anya's wishes. She has no choice but to keep silent. I'll support her. Yeah. I glance at Rutia, but she's barely paying attention, her mind clearly on the problem at hand. Talking to her now could stir up the two siblings again. It wouldn't be a good idea. I'm interrupted from my ruminous by a voice calling to me. As I watched him exit the chamber, a small sigh escaped me. Indeed. Oh boy. We throw back our cups, draining them in a couple quiet moments. Yashma puts down his own cup, then begins to speak. Yashma falters slightly, though it may be a little late to have second thoughts. I speak up to make it easy for him. Yep. I'm rewarded with a guilty smile. Yashma seems to finally come to a decision at my pressing, and he lowers his head, placing his hand against the floor. Please don't tell me it's like, please spare Rurutie. To the Imperial family. She's one mean sister, but caring still, and kind of cute, so I forgive her for that.
勝てる気が全くせんのだ。
貴殿の姉上。 シス殿であったか。 しかしなぜ
彼女はそこまで。 Oh, we're getting a backstory. Yashma pours himself another cup in pensive silence, then gulps down the drink. He takes a slow breath as he sets the cup down. Once he apparently steeled himself, he begins to speak in a solemn tone.
あの子を褒めすやす。何にそれでいて常に控えめで奥ゆかしいところがまた評判を呼ぶ。しかし姉にとっての一番の理由はフレジャイルチャイルドだけ。幼い頃は体も弱かったから幼い頃のルルティエは少し肌寒くなっただけで風邪をひきちょっと走ればすぐに転んで足をすりむいて。あっこれはアンプシルルガール。あまりにもひどい熱を出して さすがにもうダメかと思ったことさえある。その時は俺も姉上も必死になって看病したものだ。それからというも可愛がりすぎたのか優しすぎる子に育ってしまった。今思うと父上も同じことを考えていたのだろう。ルルティエに強さと見識が備わるよう姉上が嫁いだすぐに
Learn about the world. Okay, so that's why Ruti actually became under Oster. Okay. He shares some of them. Yeah. Yashma put down his cup a little forcefully. Permissive. Yeah.
ルルティエを前にすると夏の氷のように溶けるが、ああ見えて姉上のわがままに首を横に振らず、それゆえああも手前勝手な性格になった。Self-centered
woman indeed, and somewhat nasty speaking one too.
まったく姉上も国の大事に何を考えているのか。一人より国を憂わねばならぬ時であろう。しかも 我が国から正常のお蕎麦好きが選ばれる。これほどの名誉がどこにある。それは分からない。無論ルルティエも内心そう思っているだろう。俺は姉の兄だから言わずともわかる。それはさすがに思い込みが過ぎると思うが。They
may oppose each other, but Chis and Yashma are siblings with similar minds after all.
ルルティエは本当に心優しい子なのだ。
Never know independence,
indeed.
Yashma heaves a heavy sigh, having said his piece. I remain silent, watching him. He seems to notice my gaze, quickly looking up and passes the bottle forward. Have another drink. I give a wry smile as Yasma presses the bottle towards me and lift my cup, up my cup.
Now, Ruti, yay!
We're both staring, starting to feel the drink. A pleasant buzz descends over us. Wow. Oh, faint sound of a flute filters in form of somewhere nearby. The disturbance, it sounds nice. Yashma bows his head low, looking as though he's just swallowed something unpleasant. Yeah. What song is it that she's trying to play? Confident, almost. Midway through the question, the sound stops. It seems as though the flute has switched hands. Now the sound is clear and tranquil. Yashma brightens as he listens to the melody, as it is a far cry from the earlier play. Yeah. Back of my account. And so the two flutists plays, sometimes in high tones, sometimes low, one side with pride, the other with calm as the song fills the night. Yeah. Oh. Like. You know what? I know that this episode is a little shorter, but I feel like this is a fairly good time because I feel like there is going to be another kind of bigger event that's gonna happen. I just feel it. And yeah. I mean, we're still at about, like, what, 19 minutes, so I think that will be enough for this episode, actually. Enjoy this. Until next time, be cool.